Wollersheim Winery is located on a scenic hillside across the Wisconsin River from Prairie du Sac, Wisconsin.
And it was created all the way back in the 1840s. Wollersheim has now developed into a leader in the Midwest wine industry. It's won numerous awards throughout its storied history. And we are so lucky today because Celine is joining us from Wollersheim. We're so happy to have you.
Thank you so much.
And fittingly so, tomorrow I hear is National Wine and Cheese Day. I mean, that's every day for me, but I'm happy that there's actually a national day on the calendar for it.
Me too.
So what have you brought? What exactly goes well together? Please educate us.
Yes,
sure. We are here for you.
So the Cray family was kind enough to pair up with us and do this wine and cheese celebration. So we have a selection.
Okay.
And when pairing wine and cheese, I think as a winemaker and the Crave brothers as cheesemakers, mm-hmm. it's not really about our egos and what goes well together. Mm-hmm. It's really about what you like.
Oh, right? Okay.
That is my number one rule.
You can't go wrong.
You can't go wrong.
Okay.
It might not complement the best, but as long as you like it, that's all that really matters to me as a winemaker.
Okay. Well, we like to think we're sophisticated, right? So give us some guidance at least.
Yeah, so if you're gonna have a soft, sweet, creamy cheese mm-hmm. like this mascarpone, that's chocolate, and then there's a traditional creamy one.
Oh. Ooh, okay.
It's good
okay.
with something either sweet, like the port,
okay.
or a little bit light and fizzy, lighter like the Prairie Fumé, nice and fruity,
okay.
or like the Wollersheim White, that has that little bit of fizz. Ooh. It helps cut through that creamy fattiness mm-hmm. of the mascarpone.
Okay.
If you have a fresh mozzarella, like the medallions here, something like the St. Pepin, which is a Wisconsin native grape mm-hmm. and a state grown on our sites, this is really nice with something that has a little bit more meat to it.
Okay.
It's great with tomatoes, your traditional fresh mozzarella pairings.
Okay. As far as the St. Pepin goes, that's not one that I'm used to having very often. What kind of white is that exactly?
Yeah. That's one of our newer wines.
Okay.
It's one of my babies.
Oh.
Ooh,
and
okay.
it is made with the St. Pepin grape, so it's
okay.
more a Chardonnay style,
okay.
but a little bit lighter and fruitier.
Oh.
You know, Celine, I gotta be honest with you. I don't know a lot about wine. I'm learning to mm-hmm. love wine, so for somebody like me who doesn't know, where should I start? Where do I begin?
Yeah, I think, again, go with what you know and
okay.
like, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I think if you have something that's sweet and funky,
mm-hmm.
like a funky cheese, like a blue cheese,
okay.
pick a sweeter wine. If you
okay.
have something firm and nutty, that goes with almost any red wine.
Okay.
okay.
If you have something that's light and creamy like this, pick a light, just a light fruity wine.
Hmm.
Or if you have something like a brie, mm-hmm. pick a champagne. Something like that.
I love champagne.
Cut
yes.
Right? It's
mm-hmm.
easy. It pairs with everything.
Brie and champagne. Okay. I see you also brought the Scarlet Fumé.
We did. That's
yes.
another one of our newer wines.
Yes.
The sister to the Prairie Fumé.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's a lighter, sweeter red. Super easy drinking. You can chill it in the summer or have it room temp in the winter. And it's great with something that's like a marinated cheese, something that
okay.
has a little bit more spice to it.
What exactly, you know, when we're looking to make these flavor combinations, is it really just about, you know, obviously besides our own taste buds, is it really just about finding that sort of balance? Is there any sort of trick if I'm at the grocery store or, you know,
mm-hmm.
the wine store and I'm like, oh, I don't know what to do? Is
I
there any sort of, yeah, any
yeah.
sort of
yes.
formula that we can follow?
Balance is exactly it.
Okay.
Even when we're making wine, that's what we're going for. Mm-hmm. So when you're pairing wine, whether it's cheese or desserts or anything else, you want something that won't overwhelm the cheese
okay.
or the wine.
Okay.
So you want to pick something that's not too big, not too bold, but it'll enhance the sweetness or the tannins or the acidity, something that'll balance all that out together.
Wonderful.
Excellent. Celine, thanks so much for being here.
Yes.
We'll be sure to put all of this information on our web channel on WKOW.com.
Thank you.